So we're going to make x the subject of this formula. Bit tricky because the x is currently in two places, and not only that, it's in both the numerator and the denominator. So what we'll do is we'll start by multiplying both sides by the denominator so that we don't have any fractions to start with. That'll make life easier. So when we do that, that gives us x minus a times v is x. And what we want to do is multiply out the brackets. So then we've got xv minus av equals x. So now the x is appearing twice, but at least it's not in the denominator. What we want to do is bring the terms in x onto one side, preferably the left-hand side, and everything else onto the right-hand side. So I'm going to subtract x from both sides so that we get xv staying where it is, subtract x from both sides so it disappears from the right-hand side, and we get minus x on the left-hand side. And we're going to add av onto both sides so that it disappears from the left-hand side and appears on the right-hand side. So having done that, that makes life a lot easier, because now we can get the x in just one place by factorising the left-hand side. So if we write x outside a bracket, then we've got x multiplied by v minus 1. And now you can see our x only appears once, and the right-hand side won't change. So now we can divide both sides by v minus 1, and that gives us x. So have a good look at how we managed to do that. X started off in two places, in both the numerator and denominator. We multiplied both sides of the formula by the x minus a, so that the x minus a appeared as like a coefficient or of the v on the left-hand side of it. And then we rearranged everything until we got all the terms in x on one side, everything else on the other, and then factorise the left-hand side so that the x only appears once, and then we can divide to get x as the subject. It's a good idea to check your answer. So a way of doing that would be to look back at the original formula, to choose values for x and a, to write down what v is, and then, well, let's do that. I am going to choose randomly. Let's say x is equal to 5 and a is equal to 2. So if I do that, given that situation, then v would be 5 divided by 5 subtract 2. So that's going to be 5 over 3. So what we want to do now is to check that when a is 2 and v is 5 thirds, that x does come out to be 5. So I'm looking at my formula now, the x equals av over v minus 1. If a is 2 and v is 5 over 3, using my little formula that I've just got, x is a times v, so that's 2 times 5 thirds. That's the top of our fraction. And then the denominator will be v minus 1, so that's 5 thirds minus 1. And the simplest way to work this out really is to multiply each term by 3, isn't it? So that we've got 2 times 5 in the numerator and 5 minus 3 in the denominator. So 2 5s are 10, 5 minus 3 is 2. And that does come out to be 5, which we were expecting. Remember when we were doing our check, we started off by letting x be equal to 5. So we have shown that this looks hopeful that we have got the correct answer. So it's not quite like checking an equation when you've got an actual number for an answer, but it does give you an idea if you can substitute in some numbers to see whether or not you have got the right answer.